This channel is sponsored by Loot Crate, the monthly subscription box that's always filled with surprises for gamers and geeks alike. If you're interested, go to lootcrate.com/hawk525, and after choosing your crate, type in promo code HAWK525 for a 10% discount. The link and promo code will be in the description box below. All right, what is up, everyone? Sean here with my pal Danny.
What's up?
He's back. It's been a year since we last were together mm-hmm. for our movie review. Infinity War.
Yes, correct.
Yeah,
the last big movie that came out last year.
Yeah, at least that's worth talking about.
Yeah.
2018.
Yeah, well, for me at least.
Yeah. Ever since, I mean, we've like, you know, come across other Marvel movies and stuff like that, other movies in general, and like, you know, I guess, you know, it wasn't enough for us to like, you know, come together and talk about it, but definitely with this one though, Avengers Endgame,
yes.
Endgame, this is definitely like the biggest, like, you know, film anticipated for like a very long time.
Yep.
It's been a 10-year journey.
Yep, 11 years. 11 years.
Yeah, 11 years exactly. Technically, yeah, to be exact.
Mm-hmm. 22 movies.
Oh yeah.
All leading up to here.
Mm-hmm. All up to this.
Yep.
It's already been making a lot of sales. Like, it's like number 6 or 5 and the most highest like grossing film of all time.
Yeah, it's gonna hit number one.
Yeah.
It's gonna hit number one.
We're like barely into the second weekend.
Yep.
Barely into it as we record this.
Yeah.
So I think it is definitely a strong contender for number one.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
Hopefully it'll take out Avatar.
And then there's Titanic.
For number one. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No, it should take over Avatar.
Mm.
Yeah. It should.
Yeah.
It's gonna. I think it's gonna hit $3 billion overall.
Yeah.
And it's gonna be the first movie to do it.
Mm.
My. I doubt it's gonna go to $4 million, but
now is that include only movie tickets, or is it like Blu-ray and like all that?
No, just box office. Okay.
Yeah,
all only right. Box office. Yeah, yeah. It's because I think Avatar right now has 2.8 or 2.7 billion overall.
Mm-hmm.
That's with all the 3D re-releases and all that they did. But no, Endgame, just one whole movie. They're not gonna re-release this or anything. You know,
yeah.
It's even more impressive.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, you know, just a straight run right here.
Yeah.
No 3D or like IMAX re-release and all that. No, it's just one run right here, and it's already. I'm pretty sure it's gonna take over Avatar.
Yeah,
it's gonna hit that $3 billion mark.
Mm-hmm. Yep. It's already because right now it's like 1.9 billion. So
yeah,
it's getting there. It's gonna get there.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think it'll reach it by the end of, or let's say by the end of May?
Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah,
it should.
Okay. But yeah, so it's doing a whole lot,
mm-hmm.
And there I think there's a reason why. And I'm gonna, you know, lead you in with this question. So, did you think Endgame was the appropriate film to like really end it on that saga, the Infinity Saga?
Oh yeah, definitely.
Yeah,
definitely.
Yeah.
I'm very satisfied with how it ended.
Mm-hmm.
How it ended a lot of story threads,
mm-hmm.
Starting from Iron Man 1 all the way till now. It's just a perfect ending to some of those characters.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah. So like, did you like everything like from the. Well, I don't want to spoil it too much, but like, you know, all the stuff before it all leads to the final battle, like, were you like satisfied with all that too?
Yeah, I sure was. Yeah. It's kind of iffy because it deals with the time travel and all that. You know, any story. Well, a lot of stories that are revolving around time travel is going to be tricky to write tightly and write it well.
Mm-hmm.
But I think this movie did it pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
You really have to pay attention though. Cause there's a lot of stuff to think about.
Yeah.
With this movie.
Yeah.
With what they went for.
Yeah. A lot of playing around with the concept of like, you know, time travel, like science in general.
Yeah. Well, you know, we can't get into it without spoiling it. So we just have to be, you know, just vague and just, yeah, it's going to deal with a lot of that stuff.
Yeah.
Go back and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Personally, for me, I thought I enjoyed it for the most part. But there were some things that left me hanging, and it's mostly from the final battle. I loved everything else like that led up to the final battle, like all the build up, like everything, and
Now, how many
like
times have you seen it?
I saw it twice.
Twice, yeah.
I saw it twice. This is
This
like,
is my third time
yeah,
seeing it.
yeah,
Yeah.
yeah.
So
You
I've seen it three
definitely,
times,
you
yeah.
definitely got a good amount. You definitely got a good amount. This is the first time I've done it for a very long time. Like the last movie I watched like twice was like the first Transformers movie with
Oh, really? Oh,
Michael
wow.
Bay.
That was way back then,
Yeah, way
yeah.
back when. So I haven't done that in a long time. So yeah, but this is definitely a good film to watch it, you know, at least twice. I think it's
Yeah,
a good.
it's for me, it handled a 3 hour runtime fairly well.
Oh
I was never bored in this
Oh
movie.
yeah.
There's like especially in the first two acts, there's a lot of like slow moments, but it's more like drama oriented, especially in the first act. It's just the way it starts off. The characters ha have to somehow deal with what happened in Infinity War with half of the universe getting snapped. You see how they're dealing with and what they're doing, and how they come together, how they have to move on, except for some people, especially Captain America. You've seen the trailer, not us. Some move on, but not us. But yeah, it's pretty tough. It's a pretty tough first half, and then the second half, it just starts getting to the fun stuff.
Yeah,
It's
it's a
just
roller
yeah,
coaster,
roller
man.
coaster.
It's
Yeah,
like
and
you
then
get
yeah, and then you get to that third act. It's just straight up like,
the drop, like,
yeah, exactly. It's just amazing third act. Yeah.
It's still amazing. It's still,
Yes.
it's still
Yeah.
definitely amazing. They definitely like pr they did it. They did a good amount with you know, all the stuff in that final battle. There
Yeah.
are some really cool moments.
Yes.
There's just yeah, it's it, there definitely will be some things like that would like leave the audience like or some
Yeah.
shit, you know.
Yes.
And yeah,
Yes.
absolutely a lot of gaffes. And it's really impressive, you know, for this movie because like I went to go watch it at late night, like it was like almost midnight, and there was
Yeah.
still like a good number of people
Oh,
watching it.
really? And that's on a Monday too,
Yeah,
right?
it was a Monday night,
On a Monday night, yeah.
Monday late night.
Wow.
People are still trying to see this film.
That's crazy.
And then we went to go see it on a
On
Thursday
a
night.
Thursday, and it was
It
packed.
was full
It was
house.
so full house, yeah. And people were still like cheering and laughing. It's just, people really enjoy this movie. Yeah. A lot of people are liking it.
Great. Yeah, it's a good all-around film. Like
It is, yeah.
even on its own, like I think it's a pretty good
Yeah,
film, you
I was
know.
very invested. I was invested. I've seen the movie three times. Was that 9 hours of me watching this movie, and I was never bored, ever bored. Even more, I even enjoyed it more the second and third time watching it. I like it even more because I get to focus more on the backstories, on the other little details that I really, that really sucks me in because I'm really invested in this franchise, and I really appreciate what they did in this movie. There's so many things they did in this movie, callbacks to the previous movies and previous characters, and it's just awesome. The visual effects is amazing, amazing visual effects. Directing is top notch. The music is it's you can't go wrong with the Avengers theme,
Oh
man.
yeah, the yeah, good job on Alan and Silvestri.
Amazing music. It's just the acting, even the acting was just phenomenal. Especially from the original six Avengers, kudos to them, man. They knock it all out of the park. Even Jeremy Renner as Hawkeye
Oh
was
yeah.
great, like a surprise. Like
Oh
I
yeah.
thought he did well, even though he before he's not really like a big, Marvel like
Superhero,
superhero.
yeah.
That a lot of people are gonna get into. When you think about Marvel, you think of the
Captain
X-Men
America, yeah.
or Captain America,
Or
Iron
Iron
Man, but you
Man,
never think
yeah.
of Hawkeye, really. He was just there in the first Avenger movies, but in this one, he really takes that role to the next level, and I really like the way he acted. Like, this is the best acting I've ever seen from him. And don't just it's crazy seeing Robert Downey Jr. and Chris Evans, giving
Oh,
their
they're all.
best
They
performance
gave it their
also.
all. It's like really, it's like especially for Chris Evans. I mean, those two, yeah, definitely, because like, you know, Downey Jr. came from like, you know, he had a criminal background and stuff like that, and
A lot of drug problems.
Drug problems, yeah. Just like with Tony Stark. So yeah. I think it's like very appropriate for him, and mm-hmm. and he's still Tony Stark. Like he is Iron Man. Like yeah. I think he did a really good job mm-hmm. being Iron Man, and
yeah.
So he's like pretty much immortalized as forever Iron Man.
Yes.
This is pretty much his final role or whatever, his final time as Stark, and. This is Endgame, so it's like, you know, it's a nice way to, you know, just wrap everything up. For Chris Evans, you know, he started, you know, one of his first superhero roles was the Human Torch, and mm-hmm. we all know how that went, yeah. Like, right? It's like very cheesy. And
although he, you know, it looked like he did have fun with that.
He had fun with it, yeah. But
it was just like, that movie was just
very
trash.
yeah, it was a very B movie. So
yeah, I didn't even see Rise of the Silver Surfer.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I don't know. I heard that one sucks too, but.
I saw it in like a couple of clips. I'm like,
yeah. Okay, yeah, see, so. Yeah,
especially Galactus. Oh.
So yeah, so I'm glad he got a second chance in the Marvel Universe.
Yeah, you know, when he first First Avenger, Captain America.
Yeah,
I think he was great, and he's definitely awesome here.
A lot of people don't really, you know, find that movie all that good, but personally for me, I'm a big Captain America fan because of that movie. I really enjoyed the first Avenger.
Oh yeah, me too.
I really enjoyed it. It's a fun movie.
Yeah.
A really fun movie.
Yeah, and what was really cool about it is that, you know, it really, you know, all comes together. Like, Endgame feels like a good film to, like, have all the other Marvel films, like, all come together.
Yeah, it was like a season finale.
It was a very
epic season finale.
It's a very epic finale.
Yeah.
So, yeah, like, a lot of character arcs. I think, for the most part, they finished pretty well.
Yeah.
And, obviously, the music was great, you know, like you said. All the effects and like everything else is just really top notch, mm-hmm. and I definitely enjoyed it with, you know, the Dolby Cinema, like all the sound and bass mm-hmm. and stuff, especially with the during the final battle, of course.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think for the most part, most of the characters were utilized pretty well.
Mm-hmm.
I'll explain more of that in the spoilers.
Yeah,
but everything like was just it all came together pretty well.
Mm-hmm.
That 3-hour like number was like pretty intimidating for a lot of people, but this film did a really good job like mm-hmm. pacing it out. Like,
yes.
You don't really feel like it's 3 hours.
No?
It feels like it feels quick, you know, for a 3-hour film.
Because you're just so invested in what's going on mm-hmm. in story-wise, mm-hmm. and just the way that the characters are portrayed, like mm-hmm. like I said, you know, top-notch acting,
mm-hmm.
you know, all around, mm-hmm. really.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And, you know, the bright spots, in my opinion, in this movie are Iron Man, Robert Downey Jr., Chris Evans, even Chris Hemsworth. I know a lot of people are going to be divided with what they did with this character,
mm-hmm.
but overall I like what they did with Thor. Like mm-hmm. I was okay with that because I understood what he went through in the previous movie.
It's
just, you know, oh man, that sucks, but he, you know, that's the way he deals with mm-hmm. it. Okay, well, so be it.
Yeah,
you know like they said in the movie, you know, a lot of people move on, but not us, unfortunately. You know, Thor in this movie, he not going for the head really affected him, and mm-hmm. you know, you're gonna see in this movie how much it affected him.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I mean, he did really good in his role. Really, really liked how he acted, and a surprising character that I wasn't expecting I was gonna be so invested in is Nebula.
Played
by Karen Gillan.
Mm-hmm,
I think
mm-hmm.
that's how you say her name.
Yeah, Gillan. Yeah.
She was great.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've known her acting since Doctor Who, so in this movie she took it to another level. Like mm-hmm. this was her first major movie role,
mm-hmm.
and well, since Guardians was her first movie as Nebula, but you know, in this movie she took it up to the next level, and mm-hmm. you know, I'm surprised with how much character development she got in this movie.
And
how much they focus on mm-hmm. her character too.
Mm-hmm.
So you know, kudos to her.
Yeah, definitely. It's just definitely an unexpected like thing like to come out from this whole saga. It's like character, you think like Nebula's like all right, you know, whatever, but by the time you get to Endgame, it's like dang, you know, you'll come out and be like dang, Nebula's like, you know, doing work and stuff.
Yeah.
You know, and definitely she had like, she even her she had her own like little character arc going on.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
So But yeah, other than that, like, without really spoiling everything, like, I think we've pretty much covered everything for all the important bits anyway. So like, you know, kind of reiterate what I said. Like, I think it was a good way, for the most part, a good way to wrap up this entire saga
Yes.
of the Avengers. And I'll, you know, I'll dearly miss it. It's been a long journey. It felt like a very long journey, but it was a good one. It feels very satisfying, and you know, it feels like it's like one of those things, like, you know, it's like watching a long anime coming to an end, like Dragon Ball, for example, or like, you know, anything like that. It's like, you know, Avengers definitely feels like that. It's very, very good, very satisfying. You'll feel good for the most part, but there are some emotional little bumps that you'll, you know, get into, but
Yes.
you'll come out, I think, for the most part, very satisfied. What about you? You know, any final thoughts without spoiling things?
No, I can't really say much without spoiling it. So, all I can say is just go see this movie. Even if you're not into Marvel, if you've watched at least watch a few of their movies and Infinity War, you have to see Infinity War. You have to see Infinity War in order to watch Endgame. You're gonna enjoy this movie overall, I think. I really like this movie. I had lots of fun with it.
So, I really thought about this. I mean, about the score, it was actually really difficult for me to like come up with a solid score. So, I mean, if you have one for yourself, you want to go first?
For me personally, it's it if I were to compare Infinity War and Endgame, I mean, I prefer to look at those two movies as one whole movie, like as a whole story. So, it's also like I'm like kind of like in your area, like it's kind of hard for me to give Endgame a solid score. Like to me, I think I gave Infinity War a 9 out of 10. If I could reevaluate the score, I would probably give it. I mean, I wouldn't consider it a perfect movie still. But I would probably give it a solid 9.5, like almost that perfect. It's just so fun, overall, Infinity War had better pacing. Even though Endgame had good pacing too, I was still invested. But when I mean by better pacing, I mean it had like the action, like it was more action oriented. So, it all depends how you view movies. Like I like to have fun and to look at all the action, all the special effects, and Infinity War had like it was just like a big giant roller coaster of action scenes after action scenes, So that's why I prefer Infinity War just like a tiny bit over Endgame. But overall, like character wise and emotional depth wise, I would prefer Endgame. Like it's just a like a solid ending to this franchise, to this phase at least, of our beloved superheroes. And it's just you're so emotionally invested, especially in the third act at the end. It just gets you. So we're giving scores now? Okay. So I would give Endgame a solid 9 out of 10. Yes. I still prefer Infinity War, but like I said, as a whole, I would, give Infinity War Endgame like it's just like a 10, like almost like pretty much like perfect, like just like a 9.5, 10, like it's just up there as a whole.
So for Infinity War, man, it's been a year since we've, we've rooted together, but like I think I remember I gave that one a 10 because I had so much fun watching it and stuff. It was such a like shocker, like, you know, with everything that happened in that film, of course. Like, especially with Thanos, like I didn't expect Thanos to be like that well written as a villain and stuff. A lot of surprises, a lot of good surprises there, so that's why I gave it a 10 at the time. But now I think like by now, like I would give it a it's still a solid 9, like absolutely a solid 9. So with this, you know, with everything like I experienced from Endgame, I think it also deserves a 9 out of 10 for me. I think, you know, it's I'll explain it a little better in the spoiler section as to why I feel that way. I didn't give this one a 10 out of 10 or anything like that. I even thought about giving it an 8 out of 10 at one point because yeah, it'll all make sense once we get into the spoilers. So, so yeah, so both 9s from us. Yeah. So yeah.
Go see this movie.
Mm, definitely, if you haven't already.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Yeah. Go see it. Like, yeah. Like, why haven't I seen this movie? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Go out and watch it right now. Mm-hmm. It's well worth the movie ticket, man. It's just a fun time, and it's gonna hit you right in the feels.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, yeah. I heard like a number of people like sniffling by the end of
it. I went to go see it three times, and I've heard just people just not they're just like
they're like breaking down
it's very very emotional. Mm-hmm. Very emotional. Let's just leave it at that.
Yeah. All right, well, I think that's it for now with no spoilers. We're gonna go into spoilers, so if you guys don't care about spoilers, or if you guys already checked out the film, you guys can stick around and listen to our thoughts with the spoilers and stuff. So we'll be right back. Don't go anywhere.